Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're going to be running this sample of some stuff that came from Mexico. These are little tiny motors off something, and inside there's this little armature, and the armature has copper and steel in it, and we need to break this open and get the armature out in one piece so that we can then reprocess further through the hammer mill for the copper and separate the steel. So we're going to run these units whole through this 24 by 16 HD hammer mill. There is no screen in it. We just want to break these apart and get these in one piece. We'll hand sort these out, and then we'll put the screen back in at about a half inch slot so we can liberate the copper and the steel out of these. So I'll run this thing and see what it looks like. So here's the results of our test with no screen. And this is the magnetic fraction. And we hand sorted out the material that still has copper in it. So all these we're gonna have to reprocess. This is all the material that came out under the crossbelt magnet, but doesn't have any copper. So now we've changed our screen to a half inch by about a 3.5 inch slot. And we're gonna run these guys, which are the ones that the customers handpicked or hand disassembled. So we can liberate all the copper and the steel out of these ones. Then we're gonna run, this is the stuff we got from when we ran no screen. This is where all the copper and the steel is. So we're gonna run those. And then just for being thorough, I saved out 3 or 4 whole motors that we're gonna run through a half inch slot as well. So we'll run this one first, this one second, and this one third, and we'll see what the results are. So here's the results from our armatures with a half inch screen that they've already been removed from all the plastic and everything else. And it separated really pretty good. We have the copper fraction or the non-magnetic fraction here. And then we have the steel fraction here. And like I say, the steel separated pretty good. There are a few, like this piece right here, where it didn't get fully liberated from the steel, so the copper kind of got wrapped up in there. But as you can see looking in the bucket, there's hardly any steel in there. This is the copper non-magnetic fraction, and every once in a while there's a little tiny piece of steel that gets through, but as you can see, this is, you know, pretty much pure copper, 99% plus. So I'm real happy with the results. This is by far the cleanest we got. And it was because they'd already hand separated everything and removed the armature from the plastic and everything else. So we got really good separation between the steel and the copper, and I'm real happy with the results. So here's the results from our second test, where we ran the motors through the hammer mill with no screen and pulled out the copper bearing part by hand. And then we ran it through the hammer mill again with the half inch slot. And you can see we got really good separation of the steel and the magnetic fraction. And this is the non-magnetic fraction, and this is all the little brass fittings, copper wire, plastic, and everything else that was non-magnetic. So depending on how clean the customer wants it, maybe they're just trying to separate the steel or the magnetics from the non-magnetics, this would be another option for them if they don't want to hand dismantle each little armature out of that motor. And then here's the results from our third test, where we ran the whole complete motor with plastic and everything through the hammer mill at half inch minus. You can see the results here side by side. Good separation of the steel and the magnetics from the non-magnetics. But as you can see, there's a huge amount of plastic compared to the copper. So the other option for these two samples that have a lot of contamination in with the non-ferrous metals is you could take this material and run it through a 16 by 12 hammer mill with a quarter inch punch plate screen or even a 1.2 millimeter slotted screen, and then run it onto our wet shaker table, and you can get really clean separation of the copper and the plastic using a water shaking table. So that's another option for people who are looking to separate non-ferrous metals from lighter material like plastic and paper. That's there's no other way to do it other than by density separation. So thanks for watching our video of our 24 by 16 HD hammer mill and scrap line. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you'd like any more information on any of our products, please give us a call or email, and we'll see you in the next video.